Maharashtra is a state in the Western Peninsula region of India, occupying a substantial portion of the Deccan Plateau. Maharashtra is the second most populous state in India, as well as the third most populous country subdivision in the world. It was formed on 1st May 1960 by splitting the Bilingual Bombay state, which had existed since 1956, into majority Marathi-speaking Maharashtra and Gujarati-speaking Gujarat. The state is divided into 6 divisions and 36 districts. With the state capital being Mumbai, also the most populous urban area in India, and Nagpur serving as the winter capital. The Godavari and the Krishna are the two major rivers in the state. The forest cover in the state is 16.47% of the state's geographical area. Out of total cultivatable land in Maharashtra, about 60% land is under food grain crops, with jowar being the dominating crop. Let's take a look at some monuments in Maharashtra. The Rajabai Clock Tower is a clock tower in South Mumbai. It is in the confines of the Fort campus of the University of Mumbai. It stands at a height of 85 meters. The tower is part of the Victorian and Art Deco Ensemble of Mumbai, which was added to the list of World Heritage Sites in 2018. The Gateway of India is an arch monument built in the early 20th century in the city of Mumbai, India. It was erected to commemorate the landing in December 1911 at Wellington Pier, Mumbai, of King Emperor George V and Queen Empress Mary, the first British monarch to visit India. Nicknamed as the Town of Temples, Wai is home to over 100 temples and is famous for its ghats on the banks of Krishna River. It is also famous for its Dholia Ganapati temple on the Ganapati Ghat. Once known as the Virata Nagar, Wai was a cultural leader and a town of prominence in the Peshwa era. Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus is a historic terminal train station and UNESCO World Heritage Site in Mumbai, Maharashtra, India. The tomb of Salabat Khan II is also commonly known but mistakenly known as Chand Bibi's Mahal, Chand Bibi Palace, or similar variations. It is a three-story stone structure situated on the crest of a hill. 13 km from Ahmednagar city, the tomb is about 3,080 feet above sea level. On the top of a hill, 700 to 800 feet above the city, offering good views of the surrounding landscape and visible from almost anywhere in the city. Let us explore the mouth-watering delicacies of Maharashtra. Kodimbir Vadi is a popular Maharashtrian snack made from the fresh coriander leaves, gram flour, and spices. Purachi Vadi, also known as the Sambar Vadi, is a famous snack in the eastern parts of the Maharashtra state. It is a popular snack in the Vidarbha region, where it is also known as Sambar Vadi. There are two versions of this. The sweeter version of the snack, whereas in Kolhapur, you will get the spicier version. Batata Vada, an Indian vegetarian fast food in Maharashtra, consists of a mashed potato patty covered with chickpea flour, which is then deep fried and served with hot chutney. The vada is typically around 2 or 3 inches in diameter. Misal pav is a popular dish from Maharashtra. It consists of misal and pav. The final dish is topped with farsan or sev, onions, lemon and coriander. It is usually served with bread or rolls, toasted with butter and buttermilk, or dahi and papad. Puram Poli, also known as Holege, Obattu or Bobattu, is an Indian sweet flatbread that originates from Maharashtra and southern India. Now, let's check out the dressing in Maharashtra. Paithani Sari is a variety of sari named after the Paithan town in Aurangabad from the state of Maharashtra, where the sari was first made by hand. Present day, Yola town in Nashik, Maharashtra is the largest manufacturer of Paithani. The dhoti, also known as panje,
dhoti, mardani, chadra, dhotar or panchi is a type of sarong tied in a manner that outwardly resembles loose trousers. It is a lower garment forming part of the national or ethnic costume for men in the Indian subcontinent. Choli is a blouse or a bodice-like upper garment that is commonly cut short, leaving the midriff bare. It is worn along with a sari in the Indian subcontinent. The choli is also part of the Ghagra Choli costume in the Indian subcontinent. Kolhapuri chappals are Indian handcrafted leather slippers that are locally tanned using vegetable dyes. Kolhapuri chappals or Kolhapuris, as they are commonly referred to, are a style of open-toed T-strap sandal. Now, let's have a look at art forms in Maharashtra. Koli is the dance form of Koli fisherfolk of Maharashtra. The community has its own distinct identity and lively dances. The word tamasha in Persian language means fun and entertainment. The tamasha dance form has been believed to be derived from the ancient form of Sanskrit drama called the prasana and bhana. Pavadas are presented in the Marathi ballads form. This dance form describes the events in the life of the great Maratha ruler, Sri Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Dhangari Gaja is reckoned among the vibrant traditional folk dances of Maharashtra. This exquisite form of dance belongs to the shepherds, cowherds, buffalo keepers and blanket weavers of Solapur district, Maharashtra. Lavani is a combination of traditional song and dance which is particularly performed to the beats of dholki, a percussion instrument. Lavani is noted for its powerful rhythm. Lavani and Povada are the most popular folk songs in Maharashtra that entertain the village folks in Maharashtra. Bhaleri, a folk song, is sung to cheer the farmers working in the field. They also sing special songs during the harvesting time. Village women of Maharashtra sing a folk song called Ovi at dawn time, describing Maika, mother's home, and Sasural, husband's home. Suvasinis sing folk songs at the Halat and Ghana ceremonies in a marriage. Palen is a lullaby in Maharashtra to put a child to sleep. Artya is the folk song that appeases the wrath of deities to protect from diseases like smallpox, plague, etc. Next, let's discover the festivals of Maharashtra. Ganesh Chaturthi was being celebrated as a public event by Peshwas in Pune since the time of Shivaji Maharaj. With the fall of Peshwas, Ganesh Chaturthi lost state patronage and became a private family celebration. Indian freedom fighter and social reformer Lokmanya Tilak introduced a new way of celebrating the Ganapati festival as collective community worship. Janmashtami is a Hindu festival celebrating the birth of the god Krishna on the 8th day of the dark fortnight of the month of Bhadrapada. The number 8 has another significance in the Krishna legend that he is the 8th child of his mother Devaki. Janmashtami is celebrated on August 30th. Across India, there will be ceremonies and prayers at temples dedicated to Krishna. Gudi Padwa is a springtime festival that marks the traditional New Year for Marathi and Konkani Hindus along with other fellow Hindus. It is celebrated in and near Maharashtra and Goa on the first day of the Chaitra month to mark the beginning of the New Year, according to lunisolar Hindu calendar. Makar Sankranti is a Hindu festival which is celebrated on 14th January every year. In this festival, we observe the transition of the sun into the Capricorn. In this festival, they worship the sun god and observe holy baths in rivers. It is believed that taking a holy dip in the river Ganga on Makar Sankranti washes all sins. Children enjoy this day by flying kites and eating sweets. Kumbh Mela is an important event in India. It is celebrated after every 12 years. Mahakumbh is held after finishing 12 Kumbh Mela. Kumbh Mela is celebrated from last 2000 years. It is a great farewell in which people come from different places in India.
Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj Jayanti is a festival and public holiday of the Indian state of Maharashtra. This festival is celebrated on February 19 according to Julian date, celebrating the birth anniversary of Shivaji Maharaj, the first Chhatrapati and founder of the Maratha Empire. Some people celebrate this day by Hindu calendar in Maharashtra.
The Ellora Festival is the festival of classic dance and music organized under the backdrop of the Ellora Caves. This festival, which is organized by Maharashtra Tourism Development Corporation, MTDC, in the month of March, showcases the best talents from across the country in the field of classical music and dance.
The Kala Ghoda Arts Festival is an annual festival, 9 days long, commencing always on the first Saturday of February and closing is always on the second Sunday in February, in the Kala Ghoda area of South Mumbai. From its inception in 1999, the festival has grown in stature and popularity, attracting visitors and participants from other parts of the country and the world.
Nag Panchami, an important festival in Maharashtra. Nag Panchami is celebrated in the honor of the snake god Sheshanag on the fifth day of the holy month of Shravan.
Snake worship is an important ritual in India, and on this festival, cobras made of clay are venerated in homes. In the month of Shravan, the full moon day is celebrated in different parts of Maharashtra and is known as Narali Parunama. During the monsoon, the sea is unsafe for fishing and hence fishermen do not venture into the sea. Narali Parunama marks the end of the monsoon and the beginning of the new fishing season, and fishermen appease the sea god before sailing out in their beautifully decorated boats.
Of the eastern Himalaya, Sikkim is notable for its biodiversity, including alpine and subtropical climates, as well as being a host to Kanchenjunga, the highest peak in India and third highest on earth. Sikkim's capital and largest city is Gangtok. Sikkim is renowned for its dazzling and appealing beauty. The charm of this state is ever enticing and no one can abstain from its allure. In fact, Sikkim is resplendent with not only its natural beauty, but with its art and craft too. The cultural richness of Sikkim is visible in its quality handicrafts. The government of Sikkim is making constant efforts to keep the arts and crafts alive. Keeping the idea in mind, the government has established Handicraft and Handloom Institute to preserve and promote traditional cottage art and craft of genuine Sikkimese design.
Let's have a look at the main tourist attractions in Sikkim. Located around 140 kilometers west from Gangtok, the monastery was founded in 1705 by Lama Lotsen Tempo and is one of the oldest monasteries in Sikkim. Pemyangte Monastery was built for pure monks, Tathang, meaning monks of pure Tibetan lineage. Celibate and without any physical abnormality, this practice is still retained. Covering an area of around 849.5 km and located at an elevation of 1,829 meters to 8,550 meters, Kanchenjunga National Park is also a biosphere reserve and one of the few high-altitude national parks in India. The park is covered with vegetation that includes temperate broadleaf and mixed forests consisting of oaks, fir, birch, maple, willow, etc. Nathula Pass is situated at an elevation of 4,310 meters above sea level and is an offshoot of the old Silk Route.
The flow of tourists is regulated by the government of India as the soil here is shallow and prone to landslides. Nevertheless, this is a must-visit site as the location is a hiker's heaven, as it offers picturesque views of the valley. Sango Lake or Changu Lake is located on the north of the Nathula Pass and is a glacial lake in Sikkim. The lake is situated at an average elevation of 3,780 meters above sea level. It falls in the restricted area and hence an inner permit is required by Indians to visit this place. Foreign nationals are not permitted to visit this lake without special permission. The lake is about 1 kilometer long, oval in shape, 15 meters deep, and is considered sacred by the local people. Although the zoological park doesn't actually lie in the territory of Sikkim and is actually located in Darjeeling, is however only at a short distance of approximately 50 kilometers from Sikkim and is a must-visit spot if you want to gander at the various fauna that this zoo houses. Also known as the Padmaja Naidu Himalayan Zoological Park or the Darjeeling Zoo, the park was opened in 1958 and covers an area of 67.56 acres and is located at an altitude of approximately 7,000 meters above sea level, making it the largest high-altitude zoo in India. Rumchak Monastery was built in the 16th century around the same time as the other two monasteries established by the 9th Karmapa Wangchuk Dorje and was the main seat of the Karma Kagyu lineage for some time and was eventually abandoned to ruins. When the 16th Karmapa arrived in Sikkim in 1959, he decided to rebuild the monastery as the site was considered highly auspicious. The capital of South Sikkim district, Namchi, is located at an average elevation of 1,315 meters above sea level. The area is fast growing into a tourist destination with its enormous potential for all-round tourist activities. The Namchi Monastery, Ralong Monastery and Tadong Hill are important Buddhist pilgrimage centers. Located at an average elevation of 1,700 meters above sea level, Kitiyopadri Lake is a sacred place for both Buddhists and Hindus and is situated in the Kitiyopadri village in the West Sikkim district. The name of the lake, Kitiyopadri, was originally known as Khachorpadri, which means the heaven of Lord Padmasambhava. Along with the two other monasteries that belong to Kagyu sect of Tibetan Buddhism, Fodong Monastery was founded by the 9th Karmapa in the 18th century. However, the monastery was rebuilt in the 20th century, although the old mural paintings and frescoes were preserved. With a monolithic elevation of 8,568 meters above sea level, Mount Kanchenjunga is the world's third highest peak and the highest peak in India. Located on the boundary between Sikkim and Nepal, the mountain is a trekker's heaven and is considered to be one of the most challenging trek spots. Apart from the aforementioned 10 places, Sikkim has plenty more things and places to explore, and with its diverse climate and rich and unique cultural heritage, Sikkim is a must visit. Bagshapa is a strip of pork fat that is stewed with dried chilies and radish. A spicy and tangy endeavor of this Sikkimese dish is rich in proteins and is made with no oil. The Golden Dragon Hotel in Gangtok serves the most authentic and delicious bagshapa in the whole of Sikkim. Kinema Curry, Cuisine of Sikkim. Kinema is a traditional fermented soybean food having characteristic stringy property with unique flavor. Commonly consumed as a main side dish curry, served along with cooked rice in meals. A Nepali dish, Kodoko Roti, has been adapted through Sikkim as a dish of its own. The dish is a simple bread meal, typically served with pickle. With kodo flour or finger millet flour, the batter is kneaded and spread across a banana leaf. The leaf is then covered and baked on a tawa. Sail roti is a traditional homemade ring-shaped rice bread originating from Nepal, which is sweet in taste. It is mostly prepared during the Shine and Tihar, widely celebrated Hindu festivals in Nepal and Sikkim and Darjeeling regions in India, where ethnic Nepalese people have presence. Churpi or Durkha is a traditional cheese consumed in the Himalayan regions of Nepal, Sikkim, Darjeeling, Kalimpong, Bhutan, and Tibet. The two varieties of churpi are a soft variety and a hard variety. It is known to be native to Tibetan culture areas, spreading to Nepal and India. The bakhu is a variation of the garment worn in Tibet. It was worn as a long coat with a belt called patuka. The thokro dam is the primary outfit for the Lepcha community members. Usually the Lepcha bread makers sport this. Let's have a look at art forms in Sikkim. Music in Sikkim. Music of Sikkim ranges from traditional Nepali folk music to westernized pop music. The ethnic communities Lepcha, Limbu, Bhutia, Nepalis constitute the music, which is an ingrained part of Sikkimese culture. The main traditional style is the Nepali folk music known as Tamang Selo. This music of the Tamang community is performed to the rhythmic sound of Dhamfu, a musical instrument. Western style pop is popular in the region, as well as Western style foreign music styles. This beautiful dance is presented on marriages. Maruni dancers wear multicolored costumes and heavy ornaments. Maruni dancers are usually focused by a clown known as Dhatuvarai. Chufat is considered as the oldest folk dance of Sikkim that belongs to the Lepcha group. The presentation of the dance is held according to Tibetan calendar, which is 15th day on the 7th month. The dancers dance on a lot of devotional songs. The mask dance is a famous dance of Sikkim. The mask dance is divided into different types, Inchi Cham, Rumtek Cham, and Gautar Cham. Crafts of Sikkim. One of the most popular handicraft objects of Sikkim includes a choksi table, woolen carpet, canvas wall hanging, chankas delineating painting on various aspects of the state. The state has various handcrafts in the form of cane and bamboo products. Next, let's check out the festivals of Sikkim.
Losung is the Sikkimese New Year of the Bhutia tribe, celebrated every year at the month of December.
The Drukpa Teshi festival usually falls on the month of July or August of every year. This festival is a significant one for Buddhists.
Saga Dava, or the Triple Blessed Festival, is an auspicious month for the Sikkimese Buddhists, with prayers held throughout the month in various monasteries. On the full moon of this fourth month of Tibetan calendar, celebrated as Buddha Purnima in the rest of India, is the main celebration.
रतनयाना मोल आके दुनिया में गुजरात मारू मोखरे। Gujarati, Modi ji Gujarati, Gandhi ji Gujarati, Modi ji Gujarati, Gujarati ne bolbala.
Hame lari lala, hame lari lala, hame lari lala.
Dear friends and beloved teachers, I'm Jasna of 7th B. I wish to tell about topic of Gujarati traditional food and cuisine. Gujarati food is very healthy food. The people of Gujarat are mostly vegetarian and encourage non-vegetarian friends as the vegetarians. Their traditional dishes are not spicy. Most of the Gujarati recipes made with a combination of leafy vegetables. People follow in the old tradition to prepare food recipes. People eat the staple food which contains a large amount of nutritional value. The vegetable food had mild spices. Gujarati sweets are famous all over India. People at coastal area use tomato, sugar and lemons in the food to keep the body hydrated. The rotis with dal or khadi, sabzi, shak, rice and variety of homemade pickles made the taste of meals rich. Vakar is a blend of spice mixed with oil and drizzled over dal to bring extra taste to dal. Almost all households use ingredients like lentils, sesame seeds and yogurt in Gujarati dishes. Gujarati food prepared in three varieties. Mainly used in grains are parsa, sweets, rice, puri, chapati, and yogurt. Khaman dakla is the famous food made with the salty steamed cake. Ondia is the main vegetarian dish made with the potato, green beans, and brinjal and cooked in an earthenware pot in the fire. Khichdi is the another variety of Gujarati food made with the lentil and rice. With this dish, people use yogurt curry and chopped vegetables. They prepare the snacks like chakli and sevandia by using wheat flour and chickpea. The main sweet dishes are dodhpak, nangatais and kris, which is very tasty. Surat is very famous for ghee sweets, especially karis. Sweets prepared with butter, thickened milk and dried fruits. Muslim people prepare some variety of dishes with the beef and mutton according to their tradition. Some Gujarati famous food items. Gandhi is the famous Gujarati snacks made with the gram flour, coconut, curry leaves and mustard seeds. Another food is undia, the staple food of Gujarat. This curry made with the winter veggies like shrodi papadi, brinjals, potatoes, bananas and methi. The other famous food is thali. Thali is Indian staple food used for lunch and dinner. Thali consists of homemade bread, rice, roti, a shak or sabzi, dal, lentils, chickpea, gravy, vegetables, pakoras and spices. The snack items are samosa, patra and dokla kept in thali. Tapla is the recipe made with the gram flour, wheat flour, fenugreek leaves and spices. Undia is the main recipe in the winter season made with eggplant, potatoes, yam, bananas, beans and green beans and cooked with buttermilk, coconut and spices. It is served with puri and shrikhand. Khaman is the snack item. First take the khaman flour and mix the turmeric, salt and baking soda. Then boil the mixture and later add with the spices. Kandhi is the famous dish made with sorghum, gram flour, spices, jaggery or sugar. Gandhi eats with soft fulkas and basmati rice. So my dear friends, I summarize my words. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Hello everyone. I am Aradhi K from 7th B. Today I am here to talk about some historical monuments of Gujarat. Gujarat is home to numerous historical sites that will surely make you explore the deepest root of this place. The following are the most visited historical places in Gujarat. First one, Dwaragadish Temple, Hindu pilgrimage. An important Hindu pilgrimage spot dedicated to Lord Krishna, Dwaragadish Temple is also known as Jagat Mandir. This is one of the four Chardams and thus it had to be featured in this list of 10 historical places of Gujarat. Supported by 72 pillars, this five-storied archaeological marvel is said to be as old as 2,200 years as per the findings. Second one, Somnath Temple, the prominent Jyotirlinga. One of the most important monuments of Gujarat, Somnath Temple is said to be the first of Lord Shiva's 12 Jyotirlinga shrines. As per the findings, the temple has been reconstructed many times and the most recent change was done in 1951 by adopting Chalukya style of architecture. Third one, Nani Daman Fort, beautiful citadel. A famous landmark in Daman, Nani Daman Fort or Fort of St. Jerome is a rather small citadel. The exterior features three bastions and two doorways and a massive statue of St. Jerome on the embankment. The ancient monument was built in 1672 Anno Domini by the 12th Portuguese Viceroy of India, Dom Jerónimo. Today, the Nani Daman Fort serves as an educational institute with a view to savor. Fourth one, Old Fort of Surat, back to Tughlaq dynasty, built by Muhammad Tughlaq back in 14th century. Old Fort of Surat was primarily used as a guard against the Bills. This is among most visited historical places in Gujarat, as there are inspiring legends awaiting you. Tapi River flowing by the monument makes the landscape more stunning. Fifth one, Chambaneer Jain Temple, religious center. Chambaneer Jain Temple is one of the most significant historical places in Gujarat and date back to the 14th, 15th century. It is one of the most prominent center for Jains in the state of Gujarat and exhibits beautiful stone carvings of Tirthankara. Thank you for giving.
Gujarat is home to numerous historical sites that will surely make that you explore the deepest root of this place. The following are the most visited historical places in Gujarat.
First one, Dwaragadish Temple, Hindu pilgrimage. An important Hindu pilgrimage spot dedicated to Lord Krishna, Dwaragadish Temple is also known as Jagat Mandir. This is one of the four Chardams and thus it had to be featured in this list of 10 historical places of Gujarat. Supported by 72 pillars, this five-storied archaeological marvel is said to be as old as 2,200 years as per the findings. Second one, Somnath Temple, the prominent Jyotirlinga. One of the most important monuments of Gujarat, Somnath Temple is said to be the first of Lord Shiva's 12 Jyotirlinga shrines. As per the findings, the temple has been reconstructed many times and the most recent change was done in 1951 by adopting Chalukya style of architecture. Third one, Chambaneer Jain Temple, religious center. Chambaneer Jain Temple is one of the most significant historical places in Gujarat and date back to the 14th, 15th century. It is one of the most
permanent center for Jains in the state of Gujarat and exhibit beautiful stone carvings of Tirthankara.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Language of Tripura, a state in the northeast India, which included Kokrajhar, Tripura, and Bengal, and many other minority languages, in which Kokrajhar is the official language and widely spoken in the state, followed by Bengali. As in the rest of India, English is used. Of official purpose, Bengali is the most spoken language. Bengali is the most spoken language to the predominance of the Bengal people in the state. Kokrajhar spoken by the Tripura peoples.
I am Kishore of 7th B. I am going to present a speech based on Tripura food items. Moibru, the traditional cuisine of Tripura. The traditional cuisine of the state of Tripura is Moibru, as it is called by its people. You will always find one ingredient in the traditional food plate of Tripurian people. Burma. Burma is dried and fermented fish, which is surely a Tripura's favorite. Thank you.
I am Adil P of 7th B. I am here to present a speech about clothes in Tripura. The dress for women for the lower half of the body is called riguni in Tripura, and for the upper half of the body, the cloth has two parts, Risa and Rikutu. Risa covers the chest part and the Rikutu covers the whole upper half of the body. Nowadays, Risa is not worn. Instead, a blouse is worn by most Tripuri women because of convenience. The male counterpart used to wear Rikutu for the loin and Kamchulvi Borok for the upper part of the body. But in the modern age, very few people are wearing these dresses, except in the rural Tripura and working class. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Hi everyone. I am Rihan Mansoor from 7th B. Today I am going to tell about festivals of Tripura. Important festivals of Tripura are Durga Puja and Diwali. Puja is generally held in autumn, September to October every year. Garya Puja. Garya Puja is celebrated in Tripura, a state in northeast India. This popular religious festival is celebrated with huge fervor throughout Tripura and is the state's biggest festival. It is a week-long festival, and the last day is the most important day of the festival. Ashwagandha festival. Ashwagandha festival is mainly associated with the sacred dip in the holy river in the consecrated river. In the consecrated river, the Ashtami Kunda, the devotees take a bath, and this is considered to bring blessings of the god. Diwali festival. This festival is observed in Tripura Sundari Temple, Madaberi, Udaipur, Gomadi district. This is one of the 51 Hindu pithas of India, which is recognized as a holy and sacred place in Tripura. Thank you.
I am Shahin Shah, 7th B. Tell, I am going to present a speech based on Tripura dance. Garya dance. Garya dance or Garya dance is a dance of the Tripuri people of the Indian state of Tripura. It is performed during Garya Puja. the festival to celebrate the showing of new crops and prayer for a good harvest during the month of Baisakha in the Western calendar. The dancing processes after the middle of April. Thank you.
I am Kishore of Santibi. I am going to present a speech based on historical places of Tribura. Nirmahal Water Palace. Nirmahal literally means water palace. The place is a fairy tale royal mansion located in the middle of the Rudra Sagar Lake, which is 53 km south from Agartha. Maharaja Bir Bikram Kishore Manikya built the palace in 1930 AD as his summer residence, being inspired by Mughal style of architecture. Bhubaneswari Temple. Bhubaneswari Temple, 55 km from Agartala, located on the eastern fringe of Udaipura town by the bank of River Gomati. To reach the temple, one has to cross over Gomati River. Bhubaneswari Temple is now under the control and supervise of the Archaeological Survey of India. Maharaja Govinda Manikya built the temple. Thank you.
Respected teachers and my dear friends, a warm good morning to one and all. Today I am introducing Ansar to talking about Chhattisgarh festivals.
Festivals of Chhattisgarh. Bastar Dasara. Bastar Dasara in Chhattisgarh is dedicated to goddess Dandeshwari, the supreme power in Chhattisgarh. It has a span of 72 days. It is one of the longest festival in India. Bastar Logotsav. It represents the folk culture of the Chhattisgarh. It is celebrated after the end of rainy season. Chambaran Mela. Chambaran is one of the important pilgrims in India. This festival is organized between January to February. Chhattisgarh Rajyotsav or Chhattisgarh Foundation Day. 1st November of every year is celebrated as Chhattisgarh Foundation Day. Madai Festival. The festival reflects the rich culture and tradition of the state. It is celebrated by the Gond tribe.
Thank you, Ansar. Next, I am introducing Afwan to talk importance of Chhattisgarh.
Respected teachers and my dear friends, a very warm good morning to one and all. I am Afwan from 7th C. Today, I am here to share a few sentences about importance of Chhattisgarh. Chhattisgarh. Chhattis means 36 and garh means fort, means 36 fort. It is located in central India, formerly part of Madhya Pradesh. It was granted statehood on November 2000. It is the ninth largest state in India. The capital is Raipur. It is rich in minerals. It produces 50% of country's total cement production. It was the highest output of coal in the country with second highest reserves. It is the third in iron ore production and first in the tin production. Limestone, dolomite and bauxite are abundant. It is the only tin ore producing state in India. Another commercially extracted minerals like garnet, marble, gemstone, diamonds, etc. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Thank you, Afwan. Next, I am introducing Mohammad Rehan, it's me, to talking about different types of food in Chhattisgarh.
About Chhattisgarh food. One of the well-known traditional dishes of Chhattisgarh is idhar. Dishes like chila and pahara are favorites. They are made with rice flour and eaten with spicy or tangy chutney of tomato. Chila is made by a thick mixture of water and rice flour and then made like a plain dosa. In Chhattisgarh, the common meal had during the scorching summer is bor basi, which mainly consists of cooked rice. In water, it is mostly accompanied by pickle and raw onion. It helps maintain the water levels in the body, keeping it cool and hydrated during the hot and arid summer days. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Next, I am introducing Adil A to talking about clothing and ornaments in Chhattisgarh.
A warm good morning to all my respected teachers and my dear friends. I am Adil A, studying in 7th C. Now I am sharing about clothing and ornament style in Chhattisgarh. Okay, let's start our video.
Chhattisgarh, the 10th largest state of India, is rich in culture, heritage and immense diversity of various ethnic groups. Kachora is a typical mannerism in the tribal women from Chhattisgarh wear their sari. This type of sari is made from fabrics like cotton, silk and linen in bright and vibrant colors. The women of Chhattisgarh are famous for wearing lugda, means sari, and polka, means blouse, along with attractive ornaments and jewels, which was also an integral part of the culture and heritage. Women of Chhattisgarh accessories use of banda, a type of necklace which is made out of coins.
These are some traditional ornaments for women in Chhattisgarh. They are silver necklace, nose rings, earrings, bangles and bichia traditional ring worn on the top. That is a symbol of marriage. Okay, thank you and have a nice day.
Thanking you all to watch our videos. Have a nice day.
नमस्कार दोस्तों, आप लोगों को हमारे राजस्थान पर स्वागत है.
Hi, can you guess that? Where I am standing here? Yes, I am standing here in Rajasthan, of the greatest state in India. So, I am here to explore the Rajasthan. So, what I explored, I will tell about all of that. And some more pictures are there to see, to enjoy. Then the first one is the Rajasthan list. The states of Rajasthan. Then the next one.
Next one is present Chief Minister of Rajasthan.
This is the
present Chief Minister of Rajasthan.
Ashok Gehlot. Then next one is the food of Rajasthan. It's very our favorite part of the Rajasthan. Food. It's very variety foods are there. Cooking. So present food are panchkuta, pyaas ki kachori, then bajre ki khatti, next one, gevar is the also one of the food. I think all of you like to prepare foods and more variety dishes. So it's not variety, but it's Rajasthani food, puri and potato curry or potato masala. So it's made by Nehla, my classmate. So go and see that cooking video. You can, when you get free time, you can also make that Rajasthani food. Puri and potato masala. Okay, go and see the video of Nahla.
Thank you.
special food, puri and potato curry.
So, I think all of you like the puri and potato masala. So, let's go to next one. Main plant, that is the main plant of the Rajasthan is, all of you know that a desert plant of Rajasthan, cactus. This is a picture of cactus. Then, next one is the mirror. All the girls are very, very close to the mirror. So, this is the mirror of Rajasthan. It's very cute with silver. The next one is toys. Toys are very, very, very beautiful. That you can look this. This is the toys of Rajasthan. It's doll toys. Doll doll. It's also handmade, handcrafted. Almost all the materials are from Rajasthan is handcrafted or handmade. Then the next one is the sandals. These are the sandals of Rajasthan. These are the sandals, very beautiful with woolen threads. It's very beautiful. Then the next one is dresses. These are the dresses of Rajasthan. Okay. Then, next one is the old marriages. The old marriages are done by here. These are the old marriages done. It's by marriage between when the kingdoms kingdoms mean the kingdoms, that old marriages are this Rajasthanis. Then the next one is child dress. It's very cute with kingdoms mean the kingdoms, that old marriages are this Rajasthanis. Then the next one is child dress. It's very cute with one boy and a girl. It's very cute that this is the child dressing. Okay, then adult dressing. This is the adult dressing of Rajasthanis. Dresses and dressing also very combined. So then next we can look. Next one is state animal of Rajasthan. That is camel and chingara. This is the picture of camel and chingara. Then this is the picture of camel and chingara. And then next one is the state flower of Rajasthan, teko mela. It's also very beautiful with red. Okay, then the next one is state bird of Rajasthan, great Indian bustard. This is the picture of great Indian bustard. Then the state tree of Rajasthan. This is jamd. It's the state tree of Rajasthan. Then state fruit of Rajasthan is sangiri. This is the picture of sangiri. Then next part is all of the girls are allowed to do this. They are jewelries. These are the jewelries of Rajasthan. It's very, very, very cute also. It's very cute looking. Okay. This is the jewelries. I think almost their jewelries are silvered color. Then next one is my favorite part. Cultural festivals of Rajasthan. First one is the kite festival of Jaipur. In Jaipur. This is the picture of Jaipur. Then next one is a picture of kite festival in Jaipur. Then next one is Tej festival. This is the Tej festival. Then Makar Sankranti, Janmashtami. This is a picture of Makar Sankranti, then Janmashtami. Then the next one is a handcraft sandal, woodcraft sandal. This is the picture of sandal, woodcrafted, also handmade. Then it's the handmade bag of Rajasthan. Handmade bag. Also in our home also there will be handmade bags. This was the bag of Rajasthan. Handmade bag.
Also, in our home also there will be handmade bags. This was the one of the picture in our home. Rajasthani style bags. Then these are the shawl types of Rajasthanis. Okay. I explored this all that about Rajasthanis. I explored this all. You will also exploring in Rajasthan in this video. Okay, then let us see a dance of Rajasthanis by Shahma and Aslaha. I think all of you love that dance by Shahma and Asya. It's very beautiful. It's very cute also. So, my exploring is over. So, bye guys. It's thank you for watching my exploring of Rajasthan. Thank you.
हम सोचता हूँ कि आप लोगों को हमारे राजस्थान पसंद आए हैं। धन्यवाद।
Hello guys, I'm Shada Kes from Sun. I'm warmly welcome you all to the heart of India. Madhya Pradesh is a state in central India. Its capital is Bhopal and the largest city is Indore with Jabalpur, Gwalior, Ujjain, Satna as the other main city. The state contains 52 districts. Madhya Pradesh is the second largest Indian state in area and the fifth largest state in population with over 72 million residents.
Symbols of Madhya Pradesh. Emblem of Madhya Pradesh. Song, Mera Madhya Pradesh. Dance is Mancha. Mammal is Bara Singh. And bird is Indian parasite flycatcher. Fish is Mahshir. And the flower is Thalassa. Fruit is mango. And tree is banyan tree.
Gunshot Crunkle Sangma, born 27th January 1978, is the 12th Chief Minister of Meghalaya, who assumed his office in March 2018. Kongrad is the third child of fourth children and was raised under the influence and leadership of his father, Sri Pruna Ankitok Sangma, the former Chief Minister of Meghalaya and first Lok Sabha Speaker from Northeast India. A graduate from Wharton School of Business and Imperial College, University of London, Conrad Sangma's triest in active politics began at the age of 28 as the campaign manager for his late father. In 2008, at the age of 30, he contested for the elections in the Meghalaya Assembly and became the youngest finance minister of the state.
Meghalaya's famous food, judo, pomelio, nakambichi, diklesh, bamboo shoes, momo. Meghalaya's main food is rice. Meghalaya is home to three tribes. It is unique in cuisines. Different from the other seven sister states of Northeast to India, the staple food of people is rice and spicy meat and fish preparation. They rear goats, duck, pigs and cows and release their meat.
Capital of Meghalaya, Shillong. The largest city of Meghalaya, Shillong. Districts are 11. Governor of Meghalaya, Satyapal Malik. Chief Minister of Meghalaya, Conrad Sangma.
Chat Sakma Museum is the most important festival celebrated by the Kashi clients of Meghalaya. It is also celebrated Jayanti and Garo Hills of Meghalaya. This festival is celebrated in April every year. This is an extraordinary festival to Moose, and it is also known as Moose of Cheerful Hearts and Pool. This festival is celebrated primarily in the Kashi Hills arranged to Shillong.
Hi everyone, I'm Alaina of 7th D. I hope you all are safe and fine at your home. Today I'm going to give an information about the folk dance of Meghalaya. Are you all ready to listen to my voice? If you're ready,
it's a basically a religious festival dance. Heavenly deities are thanked for good harvest, harmony and properties. The people dance away to glory. Unmarried gods and men's partners holding an open sword in one hand and a white yak hair whisk in their other hand form a circle and dance. It is Nongkrim dance. Satsuk Mainsi. This Thanksgiving dance showing the sense of gratitude of people of Kashi Hills. This dance accompanied by drums and pipes called Tangmuri, which is called the tune of musical instrument. Lahu dance. This dance form is high on entertainment. Men and women holding arms together perform this dance. Borsati dance. It is an interesting dance from wherein the women try to knock off the turbans of their male partners.
My dear friends, I hope that you have enjoyed my video and get the information clearly. Thank you for being with me.
As we all know that the dance form is a major thing of the state. Without dance form, the state will be dull. So let's explore the dance form of
Madra, a regional specialty from Himachal Pradesh. Luchi Poti, it is essentially a local preparation of lamb intestine. Siddhu, Himachali dish, one of the famous dish in Himachal mostly. Dham, traditional feast prepared in Himachali style. Aktori is a traditional Pahari dish. Tadkiyabad is a slowly cooked rice recipe. Bay is a traditional dish from the North Indian state of Himalayan Pradesh. Chagosht is in itself equally to a royal feast and traditional Himachal recipe. Babru, a type of fried flatbread. Chane ka khatta is an Indian curry made from black chickpeas.
Apple. Benefits of apple. Good for diabetics and blood sugar regulation. Enables smoother digestion. Protecting bones. Reducing cholesterol. Boost brain power. Good for heart. Substances of apple may help prevent cancer. Persimmon. Benefits of persimmon. Loaded with nutrients, persimmons are high in important vitamins and minerals including vitamin A, C and B and many more. Excellent source of powerful antioxidant. May benefit heart health. May help reduce inflammation. Rich in fiber. Support healthy vision. Pomegranate. Benefits of pomegranate. Great source of antioxidant, minerals and vitamin A, E, K and B. Prevent cancer, lower cholesterol level, lower blood pressure, helps in improve memory, immune system booster, great for pregnant women. Cherry. Benefits of cherry. Cherry contains a hormone called melatonin which facilitates good sleep. Cherry are low in calories and contains vitamins that boost metabolism. It high source of antioxidant. It maintains pH balance, regulate blood pressure, helps in weight loss. Pear. Benefits of pear. Boost immune system. Improve digestion. Help prevent cancer. High in fiber. It balances hormones. Good source of antioxidant. Helps in weight loss. Grapes. Benefits of grapes. Grapes contains many important vitamins and minerals including vitamin K and C. High in antioxidant. Prevents health disorders. Good for hydration. Prevents blood clot. Reduce chance of heart attack, prevents cancer and good for the skin. Plum, rich in antioxidant, lower cholesterol level, prevent cancer, maintain healthy digestion, good sources of vitamin A and C, maintain blood sugar level. Nectarian peach. Benefits of nectarian peach. Reduce risk of cancer such as lung cancer. Promotes normal functioning of cells and tissue. Boosts immune system and digestive system. Rich in antioxidant. Good for eyesight. Good for skin. Apricot. Benefits of apricot. Very nutritious and low in calories, high in antioxidant, good for skin, beneficial for eyes, high in potassium, protect your liver. Pradesh. Beas River. The Beas River is river in North India. The river rises in the Himalayas in central Himachal Pradesh, India and flows for some 470 kilometers to the Sutlej River in the Indian state of Punjab. Its total length is 470 kilometers and its drainage basin is 20,303 square kilometers large. Chenab River. The Chenab River is a major river that flows in India and Pakistan and is one of the five major rivers of the Punjab region. It formed by the union of two headwaters, Chandra and Baga, which rises in the upper Himalayas in the Lahaul and Spiti district of Himachal Pradesh state, India. Sutlej River. The Sutlej River, alternatively spelled as Satluj River, is the longest of the five rivers that flow through the historic crossroads region of Punjab in northern India and Pakistan. The Sutlej River is also known as Satadri. The waters of the Sutlej are allocated to India under the Indus Waters Treaty between India and Pakistan and are mostly diverted to irrigation canals in India to include Sirhind Canal, Bakra Main Line and Rajasthan Canal.
Ravi River. The Ravi River is transboundary river crossing northwestern India and eastern Pakistan. It is one of the 6 rivers of the Indus system in Punjab region. Under the Indus Waters Treaty 1960, the waters of the Ravi and 2 other rivers were allocated to India. Yamuna River. The Yamuna is the second largest tributary river of the Ganga and the longest tributary in India, originating from the Yamunotri Glacier at a height of 6,387 meters, 20,955 feet on the southwestern slopes of Bandarpuch, peaks of the lower Himalaya in Uttarakhand. It merged with the Ganga at Triveni Sangam, Allahabad, which is a site of the Kumbh Mela, a Hindu festival held every 12 years. It crosses several states. From Uttarakhand, the river flows into the state of Himachal Pradesh.
Shimla is the capital of the northern state of Himachal Pradesh. Manali is a high altitude Himalayan resort. Dharamshala is a city in Himachal Pradesh. Dalhousie is a high altitude town spread across 5 hills. Palampur is a hill station. Kasol is a hamlet in the district Kullu. Chail is a hill station in Himachal Pradesh. Chamba is a town in the Chamba district in Himachal Pradesh. Kufri is a resort hill station in the district of Shimla. Kajir is a hill station. Nahan is a town in Himachal Pradesh. Solan is a town in the Indian state of Himachal Pradesh and the district headquarters of Solan district, the third largest municipal corporation.
Odisha cuisine is a lot about seafood because only 6% of the population is vegetarian. Panch putana made of cumin, mustard, fennel, fenugreek and kalonji. Tempers, vegetables and dals, while garam masala and turmeric are used for non-vegetarian. Dhenkanal. The key ingredients of Dhenkanal Bara are black gram, rice flour, green chili, onion, curry leaves and cumin. It is said that the aromatic fragrance of Dhenkanal Bara is so high that if you try to hide. Kendrapara. Rasabali happens to the most famous sweet dish found in the province of Odisha. The dish is soaked in the thick flavored milk and garnished with cardamoms on top. Sambalpur. Some of the most loved dishes of people of Sambalpur is Bhat Pakhala, which is recommended especially for summers to cure or avoid heat strokes. Nayagar. Chenna Poda is an authentic Odia dessert made up of cottage cheese in Odisha and Nayagar district is famous for Chenna Poda. Berhampur. The staple food of the people of Berhampur is none other than the delectable combination of freshly prepared puri along with the added flavors of upma. Bharipada. Dotted with the small restaurants, eateries and dabas, the food in Bharipada is something to savor while touring the region. Puri. Another sweet delicacy served as the morning food to Lord Jagannath at the Puri temple. Malpuas of Puri are especially famous as it cooked very differently from the rest of India. Balasore. The famous sweet shops in Balasore are Mahi Rasagolla and Jagadadri Sweets.
Thank you. eastern India. It is bordered by the state of Arunachal Pradesh to the north, Assam to the west, Manipur to the south, and the Sagaing region of Myanmar to the east. Nagaland's capital is Kohima and its largest city is Dimapur. It has an area of 16,579 square kilometers, 6,401 square meters, with a population of 1,980,602 per the 2011 census of India, making it one of the smallest states of India. Naga is an umbrella term for several indigenous communities in northeast India and upper Burma. The word Naga originated as exonym. Today, it covers a number of tribes that reside in Nagaland, Manipur, and Arunachal Pradesh, states of India, and also in Myanmar. Alangshu is also a traditional costume of Nagaland, which is worn by the rich men of the place. This costume depicts prosperity and success. The cloth is dyed in yellow and also has flowers on it. These dress designs have been made by the people belonging to the tribe only. When Nagaland became a full-fledged state on 1st December 1963, Kohima was christened as the capital of the state. One of the famous dishes of Nagaland, Akni Chukibo, is an expensive delicacy of the state. Chukibo means snails and Akni refers to perilla seeds, which are a type of herb belonging to the mint family. Sometimes, pork or agony is also added to the dish.
Oh, Pinky, kiman bi khusa hoy thake. Dimagto thanda kuribi, washing machine kini dibo.
Muk bahadur, misa de misa kwa manu. Washing machine do charibi, shilong di ki tia lu jabo.
Don't worry, my darling. Sub moi de khai de bo
kitia dikhabo
aeroplane te loi berabo
osa
delhi te selfie khichibo
wow
shopping lisbon nabi
kimana ha
budget under 5000
5000 ba ki pabo
look my heart is like a mountain
oh it's soar
I am your family captain
dangor galti kuri she itu ke sadi kur ke na bachcha bhi bishi ho jashe aru sabi dukan malik ke koi thake tai dangor lottery jitibo baki saki de rai dibo
Don't worry, my darling. Dunia sub moi dekhai debo.
Imane dikhabi ho.
Aeroplane te loi berabo. Delhi te selfie khichibo.
Apni ekla khichibi.
Shopping Lisbon nabi. Budget under 3000.
Ayale, woi woi woi.
Look, my heart is like a mountain.
The state is replete with festivities throughout the years, as all tribes celebrate their own festivals with a pageantry of color, music, and dance. A common feature is that the festivals revolve around agriculture, the mainstay of Naga economy. These festivals hark back to times prior to the advent of Christianity.
One of the coolest things about Nagaland is the fact that it is also home to the hottest chili peppers in the world, much in famous as ghost pepper, ghost chili and red naga. It is deemed to be shocking 400 times hotter than Tabasco sauce. Most of the celebrations are marked by folk dance and music, preparation of variety of food and drinking of rice beer, and in festivals as famous as hornbill and exhibition of handicraft and handloom are also done to help the tourists understand Nagaland better. Koshima, situated in the south at an altitude of 1,444 mm above sea level, occupies pride of places as the capital city of Nagaland, sharing its borders with Dimapur and Perin district in the west, Junhebotto and Fek district in the east, Manipur state in the south and Wokha district in the north. Based on the 2000 level census data, Nagaland effectively has 14 languages and 17 dialects, with the largest language, Konyak, having only a 46% share. Taku Imang is a festival that is celebrated during the first week of November to mark the end of the harvest season for the people of the Lhotse tribe in Nagaland. The significance of the festival is to celebrate rest day among themselves since they have completed their harvest and they are set for the winter. Nagaland is aptly called the land of festivals since its people enjoy celebrating life in all its different aspects. Each month is marked by a festival organized by its various tribes. The Angami tribe celebrate Sekreni in the month of February. The 10-day festival is also called Fosani by the Angamis.
Uttar Pradesh was created on 1st April 1937 as the United Provinces of Agra and Aud during British rule, and it was renamed Uttar Pradesh in 1950, giving the acronym UP. The state is divided into 18 divisions and 75 districts, with the state capital being Lucknow and Allahabad serving as the judicial capital. The culture of Uttar Pradesh is an Indian culture which has its roots in the Hindi and Urdu literature, music, fine arts, drama and cinema. Lucknow, The capital of Uttar Pradesh has several beautiful historical monuments such as Bara, Imambara and Chota Imambara.
Among the most important Hindu festivals are Diwali, Holi and Dashara, which are also observed with equal favor by Jains. 10 days of Ramalila takes place during the period of Navaratri, and on the 10th day, epithet of Ravanan is burned with great favor. The people of Uttar Pradesh wear a variety of native and western style dress. Traditional styles of dress include colorful drab garments such as sari for women and dhoti or lungi for men, and tailored clothes such as salwar kameez for women and kurta pajama for men. In all, Uttar Pradesh wedding is stuffed with ritual that continue for hours, and fun never leaves the gathering. The groom is invited on to the stage. The properties moments touch base for the kanya dan when the bride is donned out as her guardians offer her hand to the groom.
Religions in Uttar Pradesh. As per Census 2011, Hindu are majorly in Uttar Pradesh state. Hinduism constitutes 79.73% of Uttar Pradesh population. In all, Hindu form majorly religion in 70 out of 71 districts of Uttar Pradesh state. Muslim population in Uttar Pradesh is 3.85 crore, 19.26% of total 19.98 crore. Christian population in Uttar Pradesh is 3.56 lakhs, 0.18% of total 19.98 crore. Muslims are majorly in Uttar Pradesh state, forming 19.26% of total population. Islam is followed with majorly in 1 out of 71 districts.
Yogi Adityanath is the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh. Ram Naik is the Governor in Uttar Pradesh at 2014. Now Anandeben Patel is the Governor of Uttar Pradesh. Ganga, Yamuna, Gomadi, Gagra, Ram Ganga, Betwa is the rivers in Uttar Pradesh. Dudhwa NP, Ranipur WS are forest and wildlife sanctuaries. Taj Mahal is also situated in Uttar Pradesh. Karwa Chauth, Annakoot, Shitala Ashtami, Eid are the festivals in Uttar Pradesh. Hindi, Urdu, Bhojpuri are the languages in Uttar Pradesh.
उत्तर प्रदेश भारत की शान उत्तर प्रदेश अनुपम महान उत्तर प्रदेश
गौरवशाली वैभवशाली ये अपना सर्वोत्तम प्रदेश
उत्तर प्रदेश देश उत्तर प्रदेश भारत की शान उत्तर प्रदेश यह गंगा यमुना सरस्वती सरयू अति पावन बहती है नैमिष अरण्य की पुण्य भूमि गोमती सुशोभित करती है संगम प्रयाग पर महाकुंभ काशी के वासी है महेश उत्तर प्रदेश उत्तर प्रदेश प्रभु राम कृष्ण की जन्मभूमि कण कण माटी का पावन है भगवान बुद्ध का सारनाथ लखनऊ शहर मन भावन है चित्रकूट और विंध्याचल यहाँ ताज महल भी है विशेष उत्तर प्रदेश भारत की शान उत्तर प्रदेश कबीर यहाँ खुसरो जाय से सूरदास रानी झांसी आला उदल गुरु गोरखनाथ और तुलसीदास है दिव्य कृति रामायण की दुनिया को देती शुभ संदेश यहाँ का हर जवान मेहनत कश अपने हैं किसान बिजली उद्योग सड़क उत्तम महिलाओं को भी हक समान है युवा शक्ति की प्रतिभा का अपनी यूपी में समावेश उत्तर प्रदेश भारत की शान उत्तर प्रदेश जन्मभूमि उत्तर प्रदेश जय पुण्यभूमि उत्तर प्रदेश जय वीरभूमि उत्तर प्रदेश जय तपोभूमि उत्तर प्रदेश